In nuclear power plants, the heat energy produced during the fission reaction is used to generate electrical energy. The commonly used fuel for fission reaction is uranium-235. But the natural uranium we pull out of mines consists of only 0.7% of uranium-235. The rest is made up of uranium-238. Nuclear power plants need uranium with 3-5% uranium-235. Therefore, we have to increase the percentage composition of uranium-235. This process is called the enrichment of uranium. And that is the topic for today's video. Hi, I'm Benila and you're watching The Learning Curve. As I said earlier, nuclear power plants need uranium with 3-5% uranium-235, while nuclear bombs require uranium with 90% uranium-235. We don't care about nuclear bombs. As far as nuclear power plants are concerned, we still need uranium with more concentration of uranium-235 than the natural uranium. Here comes the picture of enrichment of uranium. The mined ore, which consists of uranium, is crushed and chemically treated to extract uranium. The result of this process is uranium concentrate powder known as yellow cake. This yellow cake again undergoes many chemical reactions to form uranium hexafluoride gas. Now this gas is fed into a cylinder rotating at very high speed. This rotation creates a strong centrifugal force so that uranium-238 are pushed to the cylinder walls and the uranium-235 are collected closer to the center. This slightly enriched gas is then enriched again and again in the same way until we get our desired concentration, which is 3-5% uranium-235. This final output is converted into uranium dioxide powder. It is then pressed and molded to make small cylindrical pellets. These pellets are loaded into long tubes. Several tubes are arranged in a bundle, which is then ready to be used in a nuclear reactor. In my next video, I'm going to explain the working of this nuclear reactor. Bye, see you all there.